Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Dentistry for You. I'm Dr. Mithali Behl, an endodontist and cosmetic dentist. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the CDC guidelines for sterilization and disinfection of dental instruments. So if you're a dentist, a dental assistant, or a student studying dentistry, come with me to the dental office and I'm going to show you step-wise the cleaning, sterilization, packaging and storage of dental instruments. Okay, so first and foremost, I want you to know that in a dental healthcare setting, all the instruments disinfection and the sterilization should occur in a designated central processing area. It's a separate area in a dental office which is used to perform sterilization. And I'm sure each one of you in your dental office has that separate area. This area is important because it ensures your safety, it promotes quality, and it also prevents contamination. So let me show you in this office how we have managed the central processing area. Okay, so we have divided our central processing area into two. This is the dirty area, you can also write it as a contaminated area. Over here, we receive the used instruments, we clean them, we prepare it, package the instruments and sterilize them. And let me show you the other half. This half is also called the clean area, as we have written, or you can write it as a sterile area, where we store all the sterile instruments, package them, and this in the middle is the autoclave. Okay, so coming to the first step, which is cleaning. After you've completed the dental procedure, remove those contaminated gloves. Wash your hands and put on your new or the clean gloves. Now, remove the handpiece, the suction tip that is there, the three-way syringe, and carry this tray to the central processing area. Next step is the separation of these instruments. As you can see that everything in this tray is mixed up, but wait, before doing that, remove these gloves, wash your hands, and now comes the most important part, which is wear your utility gloves. Now, what is utility gloves? As you can see over here, these are puncture resistant heavy duty gloves to provide protection to your hands against sharps. In fact, OSHA recommends each person in office to have a separate pair for themselves. But please do not autoclave these utility gloves. In fact, CDC recommends that along with this, you should also wear a proper mask, protective eyewear, and clothing to prevent splashing. Now, separate the gloves, the suction tip, the anesthetic syringe, very important. I will show you how to disassemble this syringe later. The anesthetic vials, gauze pieces, cotton rolls, and dispose them off in a color-coded trash can. The handpiece, which is very important, I will show you how to sterilize the handpiece later. If there's any sharps, like in this case we have suture, so separate all of this from the instruments. Separate burrs and keep them in a mesh burr basket. An anesthetic syringe should be disassembled into parts, removing the anesthetic vial first, disposing it into the leak-proof container, and then the needle should be removed and put it in the same leak-proof container. Coming back to the cleaning of these instruments, start cleaning them under running water. This step is optional for dentists who have an ultrasonic in their office. So you can remove the debris either manually or using automated cleaning using an ultrasonic cleaner. I'm going to show it to you by using ultrasonic as well after this step.
I recommend using a long brush for cleaning rather than using hands like I'm doing right now. Also, very important point to notice, if cleaning cannot be performed immediately due to heavy load of patients, please soak these instruments in water or detergent to prevent debris from drying on the instruments. Now, if you have an ultrasonic cleaner in your office, then this step is not required. Simply put all the instruments in this ultrasonic cleaner. Except your handpiece, please. We'll tell you how to clean your handpiece right after this. But important thing to understand is that this ultrasonic cleaner does not sterilize your instruments. It is simply used to remove the debris from these instruments with an ultrasonic wave. I'll just put this on. Oops, wait, I forgot to put my burr basket into this. Yes, this can also go into the ultrasonic. In the meanwhile, remove the tray liner, dispose it, and disinfect the tray. We usually use the Sani Cloth HB Germicidal Disposable Wipe. This contains isopropanol, benzyl ammonia chloride, which are the antimicrobial agents. Also, it is effective against SARS-CoV-2 virus that causes COVID-19. So either you can use this or any other product that contains these ingredients. For the handpiece, CDC recommends that do not use any chemical solution or alcohol wipes for disinfecting the handpiece, as it dehydrates the spores and increases resistance to sterilization. Clean it normally with any tissue or any plain napkin that you have in your dental office. Dry the handpiece and lubricate it. Let me show you what we use here for the lubrication of the handpiece. It's the W&H Assistina 301 Plus. Simply put the handpiece inside, close the lid and push the button. It has a cycle for 15 seconds. It's absolutely okay if you do not have this in your office. You can normally lubricate your handpiece using the spray that is easily available in the market. The 15 second cycle is over. Simply remove the handpiece and it's ready for packaging. Okay, so the ultrasonic cycle is over as well. Remove the instruments and rinse them under tap water. Place these wet instruments on a towel and gently wipe them to remove the excess water. Be careful not to hurt yourself from sharps. Instruments should be thoroughly dried before they are packaged or wrapped. Next step is the packaging of these instruments. The most common packaging option that we use is the self-sealing or the heat-sealing bag. They have process indicators built in them, which is pink before sterilization. Label each one with date, cycle or the load number and the sterilization number before putting them into the autoclave. You can also use instrument cassettes, which is believed that it's a more organized way with detail of every patient with the instrument. After this, quickly go and clean the sink, wash utility gloves, remove them and wash your hands and wear the latex gloves. Place the packaged instruments in the autoclave properly, making enough space between each package. Also, remember to check and fill the line of the distal water. Run the autoclave cycle according to the manufacturer's instructions. Okay, so the sterilization cycle is complete. And now comes the most important part, which is the storage of the instruments. So how should you store these sterile packets? So take out the sterile instruments and put them in the clean or the sterile area and always store them in a dry, closed and covered cabinets not under the sink, please. Can you see after the sterilization, the indicator has turned gray? We usually store the instruments in our upper closed cabinets. Can you see how we have arranged the trays? These are the filling trays, hygiene trays, the crown trays. And below are the trays organized according to the patients for the day. These are the unused trays, and this is the patient's trays for the day. Like in this patient, I'm going to use this XCP X-ray film holder for taking the bite wing. So yes, this is how we have organized it all, especially the clean area. Make sure that none of the packaging is compromised. It's not wet, torn or punctured. Always remember to open the wrapped packages in front of the patients. Before starting the procedure, the patients feel assured that a good sterilization protocol is being followed.
So yes, this was all about the sterilization and disinfection of the dental instruments. Hope it was helpful for you all. Through this video, let's train ourselves, our dental team, by letting them know the importance of correct sterilization protocol in the dental office. You can show them this video and use it as a guide, teach them, educate them, and together, let's develop the best oral healthcare practice. For questions, let me know in the comment section below. And I'll see you all next time in another video, which I'm recording right after this, on using XCP X-ray holders for taking accurate radiographs in your dental office. So stay tuned. Ciao.